TV. I am not black.
Today I'll be telling you how to do Tai Chi. First things first, I want to say the chi lies in the stomach. So what you want to do is pull the chi out of your stomach and channel it into your hands or your palm. Chi, or also known as Ashe, is the energy that's surrounding everything and that's in everything. And it's also in you. When you use Tai Chi, all you're doing is channeling that energy. A lot of people get Tai Chi and telekinesis confused. But chi is using your body energy, and telekinesis is using your will, like projecting will onto something to move it. When you do Tai Chi, you want to take a deep breath in, pull all that prana in, and then build your chi up, and then project it through your palm, because your palm is like an exit way, and also is an entry way, it's pretty much a door. Another thing that can help with your Tai Chi is meditation. When you meditate, it can help you, or if you like ground yourself or be out in the sun, just get some more, do more electric things, and raise your vibrations, and you will be able to do Tai Chi pretty easy. If this video helped you at all, leave a comment, leave a like.
Everything is energy, and you come to Earth to learn how to manipulate that, to be a master manifester. So once you learn how to manipulate energy, you can have anything you want. Nothing is impossible. There are no limitations except the limitations you put upon yourself.
I got you. So I have been practicing Tai Chi for, oh goodness, like 4 months. Started in the fall of 2021. And I found my way by, you know, through ClassPass, first off. ClassPass is this app where you can buy a couple of credits each month and you can use them at different fitness centers, studios, wherever you live. So I went to a Tai Chi class just to try it out and absolutely fell in love with it. I knew that I needed a practice that would be more energy based, and I love yoga. Like, yoga is my ride or die. But it's not everything for me, you know? So I took what I knew from yoga and kind of brought that over to my Tai Chi practice. And it's a combination of martial arts, like martial arts dance, like movement, Qigong, which is energy, it's like an energy practice, a lot of stuff with our hands. I'm not saying this the best way that I can be. Sorry about that. But I'm learning so much about how energy moves through our body. A lot about the meridian channels, which I should probably share a little bit here on this page because it's so informative, and everything in your body is connected via the meridian channels. Like, there's a meridian tooth chart. Every single tooth in your mouth is connected to an organ, or several organs via the meridians. So very, very insightful if you're trying to look for another way to help manage your health. Yeah, because it's just like focused on energy work, it's like we're moving out a lot of stagnant and blocked energy, so it's an incredibly healing practice. The first couple of weeks that I was there, I was crying every single class, and I was like angry because I was crying, but then I was like, there's more to this anger. So it's really helping me like move through a lot of emotions that I haven't been able to address before. So I'm at the beginning of my journey, and I should probably share more on it here because I feel like a lot of people could benefit from just seeing what it's like, and hopefully maybe you might try it too.
Here I am outside in my head wrapping PJs, all for my Tai Chi pleasure. I woke up feeling so tense this morning that I just had to get out and do some practice. Now, we practice Tai Chi slowly so that we can feel everything in our bodies, every movement, every spiral, every muscle, every fiber move in harmony. And that's what I'm trying to do here. Now, granted, it's not easy because when you feel aches and pains and things, and you're trying to work through the kinks, it's like trying to unclog the pipes so the water and the fluid can travel through. It sometimes gives you a little bit of what I have here, a little resting bitch face. But you know what? Who cares? It's your practice. No one needs to worry about what you're doing. And that's what I'm doing. I even didn't take the time to take off my head wrap because I just really needed to get out and work. And so you'll see a little bit of wiggling sometimes, trying to clear those pipes to allow that energy to travel through. I'm really mentally digging deep so that I can feel what's happening, so I can untangle those tangles and release that tension in my body. Now, one of the really important things about moving slowly in Tai Chi is that you actually want to be able to feel all of the little minute details and micro movements that happen in your body. You want to be able to control the weight, the transitions, and all those kinds of things. So a lot of times people are like, well, why do you go so slow in that practice? And yes, low impact, but it's also because if you just brush over the movements and move quickly, you won't be able to feel all of the tiny micro movements in between each transition. So get out there and practice. Baby girl, you are so pretty, 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 pretty. Baby girl, you are so pretty, 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 pretty. Famous girls, you're just a dream, 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 dream. Just baby girl, you are so easily me. The only reason that I can go tonight is cause I know you will invite. The only reason that the stresses can die is cause I thought that you would like it. I'm only no sorry, say what I say. Because I want you to like it. The only reason I can do tonight is because I really like you. I like you. Thank you.
To feel the energy. This is why you always do it slow. As you can see him, as he's moving into the energy. energy is literally feeding his soul. Because energy moves slow. These are all important in order for you to create a type of balance within your body, right? So it's important that we practice this on a regular basis. Do it more than often.
I believe Tai Chi is for the person who is looking for that next level of personal development. And again, it's not just about the physical. It could be to take a physical step to make it to improve something. It could be mental, it could be spiritual. But they are looking for that next ability or that next challenge that challenges all three of those that areas, mind, body, and spirit. Tai Chi is amazing. As
the river flows, this is how the energy flows when you're performing Tai Chi. If you're allowing the energy to flow from your foot chakra all the way up to your crown chakra, touching your knee chakras, your hand chakras, flowing like water, non-stop movements, continually pressing, breathing, shifting energies. Grafting your way from one area to the next. Your hand chakras are vibrating. Your heart chakra is well balanced as the energy is flowing. The wind is blowing. Everything is in balance, and this is what Tai Chi does. It brings everything in balance. Spirit, body, soul. As you charge up your body and store this energy within your solar plexus, this is where your chi is. This energy begins to grow. Remember, as the original beings, we have the elements within our bodies to store this energy. We literally have a program within us that stores energy. And then we build on top of this. Tai Chi is one of the best arts for this type of energy to be stored. Let's go back to the basics. This is where we come from. They don't want to let us know that we created this.
In the Avatar's world, the powers of the four nations are based on four different forms of Chinese martial arts.
The waterbenders, we more or less matched them to the style of Tai Chi. Tai Chi is less about strength and more about alignment, body structure, breath, and visualization. Katara uses water like a whip. She brings it in and then she shoots it out.
In waterbending and in Tai Chi, softness and breath can be more powerful than hard aggression. Waterbending.
Waterbenders are using a style called Bagua, or circle walking. The Bagua fighters are known for moving in a circle, constantly spinning back and forth. Since they're always moving, nobody can get a solid hold on them. The idea in combat is that the Bagua practitioner can get behind you and put his hand on your spine, and then you can't turn to face him. As you move, the feet are like the heavy treads on a really big truck. So you're going around this circle, so anything that gets in between the legs basically gets thrashed apart. Aang's air scooter is circular too. He moves his hands around like this, makes a strong circle of air, and then rides it.
In airbending and in Bagua, the constant circular movement builds tremendous energy and power.
Earthbending is based on the movements of the Hungar style of Kung Fu, a style known for its strong stances and its rooting to the ground. Hungar is a southern tradition of Chinese Kung Fu. The Hungar practitioner generates power by strong stepping, using low stances and strong transitions from left to right. Earthbenders, they step, a stone jumps up out of the ground, they smack it, and wham, it goes flying. Hungar is based on the movements of animals, especially the tiger, which represents hard power, and the crane, which stands for soft power. Sometimes it's called tiger and crane style.
Strongly rooted to the ground, earthbenders use Hungar skills to tap into the immense power.
Earthbenders are steeped in my preferred style, Northern Shaolin Kung Fu. It's a very strong, dynamic style that uses powerful hand and leg movements. The firebenders, they inhale and then fire moves in every direction. The northern styles of Kung Fu generally emphasize long-range techniques, wide stances, quick advances and retreats, kicking and leaping techniques, whirling circular blocks, quickness, agility, and aggressive attacks. Many styles of martial arts can trace their origins back to northern Shaolin.
Just like fire, northern Shaolin is beautiful to look at, but can be very dangerous.
Understand what he's doing. Understand how he's moving. He's flowing in the energy. Now, I believe on this right here, they cut the music because of copyright purposes. But you can see the way he's moving, and he's moving very slowly. He's collecting the energy. He's bringing it down to his solar plexus. You see that? He's coming from his crown. He's aligning his crown with his solar plexus. Because your solar plexus is your power center. All right? This is where your power lies. All right? That's it. That's your power center. That's where everything lies. So when you're doing this, doing those movements here, you literally are bringing this energy into you and balancing this energy within you. All right. You see he's using his left hand and then his right hand. So one hand contains negative energy and the other hand contains positive energy. So it's like he was doing both of them with the negative and the positive together. And then he went one negative, then one positive, then one negative, then one positive. All right, you see he's collecting the energy from the sky and he's bringing it down very slowly to his solar plexus. Alright, that's the chi ball area, and then he's coming up again, so he's collecting the energy. This is all a part of Tai Chi. This is all a part of building that energy within you. Alright, glad you all enjoyed this session. You came here to join us here. We're going to be doing some other things a little later. I think next we're going to go to, I'm not going to tell you. Catch you guys later. Much power to you all.
I am not black.
Thank you.